What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. I am so happy you are here. My name is Nicole, and today we are going to be exploring Proverbs chapter 4. Today's topic, we are going to discuss how you can be saved and not set free. So many times as Christians, I feel like we pray this prayer, we become Christians, but we're not equipped for how to go out and guard our hearts and minds. And in Proverbs chapter 4, there are a couple takeaways, six, I believe, that I want to just leave you with today to help grow your faith. Here we go. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 18. The path of the righteous is like the morning sun, shining ever brighter till the full light of day. But the way of the wicked is deep, like darkness. They do not know what makes them stumble. In order for being able to pinpoint and decipher between stumbling blocks and between what is biblically correct is going to help us act on those things. It's kind of like this, whenever you're on a diet and you're trying to lose weight, you know that eating nutrient-dense food, eating protein and healthy carbs and healthy fats are more well-rounded, whereas if you just had a diet that was completely made up of lava cakes and ice creams and Oreos and pizzas, you're not going to be able to achieve the results that you want in a timely fashion. You know what is right versus what is wrong, but acting and being committed to doing what is right is what makes the difference. Let's keep reading. Proverbs 16:9. In their hearts, humans plan their course, but the Lord establishes their steps. Verse 20 says, my son, pay attention to what I say. Turn your ear to my words. Do not let them out of your sight. Keep them within your heart, for they are life to those who find them, and health to one's whole body. Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. Keep your mouth free of perversity. Keep corrupt talk far from your lips. Let your eyes look straight ahead. Fix your gaze directly before you. Give careful thought to the paths of your feet, and be steadfast in all your ways. Do not turn to the right or to the left. Keep your foot from evil. Wow. So let's break this down. There is so much wisdom to be unpacked here. Do you ever get in your car and you don't really know where you're going, but you have an address? Let's say that you're going to meet your friend. You're going to try out a new restaurant and your friend sends you the address. So you put that address in your GPS and the GPS gives you step by step instructions of how to get to the place that you want to go. I love the Bible because it's giving us step-by-step instructions. It's saying, if you do this, this will be the result. Favor always follows obedience. The first key point that we say is pay attention to what I say. How do we know what God says? By reading His word. So step number one is pay attention to what God is saying. And you do that by reading your Bible. Turn your ear to my words. There's a reason why God gave us two ears and one mouth. Have you ever heard that before? I love that because it's so true. We have to be immersed in what God is saying. We have to pay attention. Whenever you're in school, whenever you're trying to learn something new, you listen to somebody teach you and you take notes and you start paying attention because in order to retain knowledge, you've got to pay attention. Studies have been shown that people that just hear audible learners, whenever they don't take notes, they only retain 5% of the information that they heard. But those that write down what they hear, and then those that go back and read what they wrote, retain 35% more of the information. So if you're not taking notes, go get a pen and piece of paper and come back and take some notes. Next it says, do not let them out of your sight and keep them within your heart. We need to hide God's word in our heart. In Matthew 4, when Jesus was being tempted by Satan in the wilderness after he was baptized, Jesus defeated the attacks of the enemy by quoting back scriptures to Satan. Satan was antagonizing and interrogating Jesus, and Jesus quoted back Psalms 91
to him. A way that you can hide God's word in your heart is by taking flashcards. I love the flashcard method, and writing down Bible verses. And you can literally just take this with you in your car and meditate on it every single day. You can meditate on it for the day. You can meditate on it for the week. But the goal is to memorize and hide God's word in our heart. So when we are feeling defeated, when we are hearing lies by the enemy, and when we are feeling discouraged, when we're going through spiritual warfare, we can fire off verses at the enemy. Number three, the Bible says, above all else, guard your heart. Society will tell you to follow your heart. God says, guard your heart. It is the wellspring of life. Everything that you do flows from your heart. From the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So we have to assess, are we protecting our vessel? Are we guarding our heart? Are we following what society says? God says, guard your heart. He then goes on to say, keep your mouth free from any perversity. Keep corrupt talk far from your lips. How we speak matters. Our words carry weight. What you say matters. There is life and death in the power of the tongue. One time I heard this analogy. If you are speaking ill about somebody, so many times we don't think before we speak. We need to be slow to speak, quick to listen, but slow to speak. If you were to take your pillow off of your bed right now and cut the top of the pillow off and walk outside and just sling all of the feathers in that pillow all over your yard. And if I said, go pick up all the feathers and put them back in the pillow, there would be so many feathers to pick up. We would miss some. We couldn't pick them all up, and the pillow would be a lot less fluffy, a lot less comfortable. And that's what it's like whenever we let corrupt talk come out of our mouth. Our words, we say them so fast, but we can't take them back. We need to keep our eyes looking straight ahead, straight and narrow, not to the left, not to the right, but directly in front of us. The Kentucky Derby just happened last weekend, and those horses, they race and they train for so long, and they put in a lot of time and preparation. And those horses, if they go into and veer off of their lane into the other horse's lane, they become disqualified. So every single horse that races and competes, they wear these little goggles around their eyes, and they're called blinders. They're fairly cheap, let's say $15, but those blinders amount to so much because horses get distracted. And whenever they see things in their peripheral vision, they want to run to those things, and they get startled easily. So they wear those blinders to keep them running the race so that they can win the race. Put the blinders on, stay focused, and look directly in front of you. We don't need to look back. We can't go backwards. We'll get in a wreck if we just kept our head like this when we were driving. There's a reason why the windshield is so much bigger. You are headed forward. Stay focused. Stay looking forward. Next up, we need to be wise in where we go. Where are you allowing your feet to go? There was this little song that I used to sing when I was little, and it would say, be careful, little eyes, what you see. Be careful, little ears, what you hear. Be careful, little lips, what you say. Be careful, little feet, where you go. For the Father up above, he looks down with love. So be careful. We have to be careful where we go. Lastly, we need to keep our feet from evil. Hate what is evil, cling to what is good, is what the Bible says. Here is a list of six things that we can take accountability for, that we can do an inventory analysis check. How are we guarding our heart? How are we paying attention to what God is saying? How are we speaking to other people? Are we keeping our mouth clean? Where are we looking? Are we looking? Where are we going? Are we going into places where we can hear the voice of God? Are we going into places where we can have discernment? Or are we going to the club where you can't even hear Jesus? There's a reason why when the preacher gets up and preaches on Sunday morning, the people stop speaking, the choir stops singing, it's quiet. You can't hear Jesus in the club. And lastly, we need to keep our feet from evil. The way of the wicked is dark. The light of the righteous shines brightly. I want you to be a bright light for Jesus. The way of the wise is bright. Continue to be a willing vessel. Guard your heart above all else, because everything that you do flows from your heart. Jesus loves you.